You good? You straight? You sure? All right now. Okay. So, today, I decided that I wanted to make what some may call a Southern delicacy. Now, I myself am from the South, but I have never had this thing that I am making today. I have never tasted it. I think I've seen it maybe once in my whole life, but I have no idea what it tastes like. But you already know what you're here for. We're going to make us some good old Kool-Aid pickles, okay? That's what you're here because you tapped on the lecture, you know? So everything that I have here is not in frame, of course, but we're going to make it do what it do. Okay, so I have some bowls. I have a measuring cup here. I have another big-ass bowl. Gotta have some Kool-Aid if you're making Kool-Aid pickles. Got me some sugar. Okay. I have me some pickles, because what's the Kool-Aid pickles without the goddamn pickles? Okay. And then I have a good old knife here, as well as some gloves on the side. Now, the reason why I have gloves, other than the fact that I like to use gloves, is because I am the neighborhood candy lady. Yes, I know. Yeah, it's me. I am the neighborhood candy lady, and I am always trying to find something new to hit these people over their heads with, you know what I'm saying? And make them smell a little strange with me. So, yeah, I just know that Kool-Aid pickles are a Southern delicacy. I feel as though maybe they're more of a thing in maybe like Florida, because being from Louisiana, I've seen it before, but I've never really seen it before. Just like I've seen, like, I know pickle pig's feet. I know corner store shit, pickle eggs. I know shit like that. Ball peanuts. I know that. But Kool-Aid pickles, I've hardly ever seen it. But I know in movies and stuff, you see it sitting right on the counter next to the pig feet and the eggs. So I ain't got the pig feet and the eggs. I probably won't have that. I ain't going to try to do that to the city. You know, I ain't going to try to do that to my peoples. But, but I'm definitely going to try these Kool-Aid pickles. Now, these are actual pickles that I bought to sell. I've only sold like maybe 3 or 4 out of this whole entire jar. So I decided, since they're not really selling, let me just play with them. Again, I've never made Kool-Aid pickles if they don't sell, in the event that they don't sell, which is totally fine with me because I'm fine without giving out samples and all that shit. But in the event that they don't sell, they'll be for the family. Like, I got kids and my kids can eat them. My daughter's getting ready to come back. Actually, when it's time to open these things up and check on them to see how they taste, my little taste tester, one of my top taste testers, will be back just in time. So let's get on up in this thing. All of the things that I have here are already clean. If you can't already tell, I've cleaned my kitchen. So I'm just gonna put on some gloves. Ooh, child, bear with me. I am feeling lightheaded like a mug. I got my little water over here, even though when I'm doing stuff for other people and stuff like this, I don't really like drinking and doing that around stuff that I'm trying to give out to other people. So, yeah, but I'm just like, not too long ago, you know, getting over some things. I'm fine enough to be around this stuff. I just sound like this because I'm a lot more immunocompromised than the people in my family because of my asthma situation. So it takes me a lot longer to get over things. Okay, so I looked up a recipe today as far as how to make this, and I specifically found a recipe that used a jar that was this size. I was so happy when I saw the lady. Her name is on YouTube, Lady D's Dishes or Lady D's Delicious Dishes or something like that. So shout out to Miss Lady D. But she had a jar this same size right here, and she used 2 cups of sugar for it. So that's what we're going to do. But being that I am making 3 different kinds, I'm going to do this a lot different than what she did. So basically in the video, what she did was she took her pickles. She kept the juice in the jar. She just took her pickles out the jar. She cut her pickles up, did all that stuff. Now, as far as making the actual brine that the pickles go back into, she just left everything in the jar. She just mixed it up in the jar. Now, however, I will be doing that. I won't be mixing it Yeah, I'll be mixing in a jar. I'll be mixing the sugar with the pickle juice in the jar, but then I'll be separating it into its respective places because I want to have three different flavors. And then I'll be adding the Kool-Aid, and then I'll be adding the pickles. So let's get started, shall we? This bowl right here is for the pickles as I take them out of the jar. I don't know how many. Ooh, pickles. I love pickles. It smells so good. Let me bring this over here because I'm a big stickler with messes and clean as you go. The one thing I did not say that I had over here was some damn napkins. And I love me some napkins now. Trying to keep as much of that brine or that juice in there as possible and not really get a lot of that out there. I think that's it. I have not taken any of the juice out of here or done anything, you know, to it, whatever. Let me get some napkins. They right here. They right here. They ain't for. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and do that like that right there. Yes, I am. Actually, you know what? No. No, the heck I'm not. I'm not. Because I got to put my hand in my sugar. That's why that extra glove right here. So I got my other glove. All right. Now, before I actually go into cutting up my pickles and stuff, I'm going to just go ahead and do this part. Woo, child. So I can set it to the side. That is the condensation. It is slippery. Let me get a spoon because I also did not get a spoon. Let's see here. Let me wrench this off. Okay. Okay. So I got my spoon. This is for me to mix the juice. Let me get this cup here and replace this. And I get 2 cups of sugar. This measuring cup, once I get to the top, the very tippy top, is 2 cups. So we just gonna do that. Do it to it. If you didn't know, that's how you're supposed to measure like sugar and flour. Yeah. That's how you're really supposed to do that shit. Now just pour like this and be like, it's 2 cups. Did you flatten it? All right. So we are actually over 2 cups, look like on one side. Hold up. We just a little tad over 2 cups look like. On one side, it seemed like it's not over 2 cups. And then on the other side, it's like, oh, you finally, that spirit. That's my cat finally going pee. We just got spirit today from the shelter. We adopted her. And she is just now going to pee. All right, I'm taking this sugar, putting it into the pickle juice. Let me move this over. Get this napkin right here. The pickle juice napkin. That's right, girl. Go ahead, spirit. All right, so you can see the juice. See how much I got in there. I'm going to go ahead and pour the sugar. That's a lot of goddamn sugar. That made me think of on house party. Girl, that's a lot of sugar. It's good, though. Child. All right, so I am mixing and mixing and mixing. Now, one thing I will note is that when I first initially was watching stuff, I didn't see anybody say really stir until it dissolves. They just was like, stir it all up and then put it in the fridge. And me just with sugar, I just be stirring until shit dissolves. But then you know this ain't gonna dissolve because... Oh, okay. All right, spirit. This ain't gonna dissolve because it's cold. My pickles have been in the refrigerator. So maybe the reason why they didn't say that was because they had like fresh ass jars of pickles. This jar of pickles has been in the refrigerator for since I bought it, pretty much. And that's been like maybe going on a month now? Almost a month. Not quite. All right. I'm nervous about this because I ain't never had no damn sweet pickle. Okay. All right now. Now I'm going to keep this spoon to use to stir this up when it's time to keep the pickles for the Kool-Aid that goes in here. But for these, because they have tops, I'll be able to mix the Kool-Aid up by just kind of putting the top back on there and just shaking that shit up. Right. Okay, so now, while that's over there marinating, I'm going to go ahead and cut these pickles. So I'm going to cut them in two different type of ways. I'm going to make some spears, and I want my spears to go back into the big jar. And then I'm going to make slices. My slices will be inside of the smaller containers. Not, it kind of sucked because it's like, what if, you know, the person who likes the spears wished that the spears were in, and I kind of sort of get it. So maybe, just maybe, I might try to do spears, chips. Let's go with that. Because you never know. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pickles. 2, 4, 6. And we got 2 more pickles. So, I say maybe that pickle look like it or it been cut or something. Last time I ate that pickle. Okay, so 3. Who gonna have 2? Who only gonna have 2? I guess the jar. No, the bowl gotta only have 2. Okay, one of them is not gonna have spears. One of them is just gonna have chips. One of them just gonna have chip. That's what we gonna have to do. Okay, so let's go ahead and pop these tops off of here. Pop this top off of here. All right, so I'm gonna just go ahead and start making some chips. And because this one only has 2 pickles in there, I'm gonna cut them kind of small. I just realized something. I'm doing this, but I'm not. Okay. Because how I'm going to know? I can't put it back in there just yet. Oh, you know what I should have did? After I made that, I should have. You know what? We're doing this as we go. I've never done this before. So many things that I'm thinking of now that I'm like, damn, I could have did this like this. I could have did this like that. I don't think anybody cares that I'm cutting and wants to see me actually cutting. But you never know. Where did you see that? Girl. You see that shit up out of there? You better not have none of that kitty stuff on your feet. Walking it all over my goddamn. Okay, that's 1. And then we got the other one. So I said spears in a sense. Oh my god. Okay, let's see. Let's go long ways, right? Let's go long ways, right? Right? And you could cut it like this. I don't know why I'm making this shit difficult. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4. I could cut them in half. Let's cut them in half. Let's do big spears. Big Britney energy, bitch. Big spears. But everybody gets the same amount of chips. 2 chips, 1 spear. And it's 3 pickles. See, if I wouldn't have gave away that 1 pickle. And I want to try to keep the thickness of the pickles pretty thick. Not too thick, but just, you know, because I know that it's like, girl, because I know that it's a lot of sugar. I don't know. I just feel like maybe I should keep the pieces kind of thick. Don't be saying that by my counter. My counter is clean. I clean my counter every night. I clean my kitchen every night. Because I got kids, and my mornings, my AMs, is for me to do me, not for me to be cleaning up. I will clean up in the morning, especially if I was sick or something, child. I will, because I ain't had no choice. But That's not the time for anything. Mm-hmm. That's my time to relax, release, and relate. All right, so we got the last ones. They're going to go right over here. And we're going to use this little weird shape one for the spirit. So we'll do that one last. And then somebody going to be like, are you cutting it, lady? Okay. I like cooking. I like being in my kitchen. I like doing stuff because it's like, I don't know. It's just something about it. I could be in the kitchen for like 4 or 5 hours just cooking. That's dedication right there. That's love. That's dedication. I just like cooking for people. I didn't realize that until I joined the military and became a cook. I didn't even know I liked cooking. I just joined it. I just chose cook because they was giving away money. And that's how they sold me on it anyway. That's how they gave it to me. They presented it to me like that. Oh, you could pick this job and you'll get, you know, well, I should've said that. You'll get this amount of money. Okay, then you should just sign me up. All right. So there are my three cut up sections. Let me take this away. All right, I'm gonna take these gloves off because I got enough gloves, Jack. I got a lot of gloves. All right, let me just clean up because I like to clean as I go. That's what I learned. Don't have much of a mess if you continue to clean as you go. All right, so here we are. We got our stuff, right? Here's our bowls. Got all my pickles everywhere. So first, I'm not even sure how much, but we just gonna kind of eyeball it. It was kind of big. It's a little bit more. That seems about right to me. Okay, so I have strawberry kiwi, blue raspberry lemonade, and cherry. Now I'm hoping I don't need two of these because these is my money makers, not the Kool-Aid. I make, I don't know what you want to call it, where you call frozen cup, Dixie cup, Huckabuck, ice, whatever. My baby say ice. But yes, I make those. So these is my money makers. So I'm hoping I don't have to use that many. I'm hoping I only have to use like one of each. But I took out two just in case, like, for instance, I don't like the color. I want the color to be a little bit darker or whatever. So we got cherry. Yeah, that's so good. I'm gonna get 2 spoons. I'm gonna mix it up. There you go. I was like, I feel something new. We got the blue raspberry. Yes, I do. It really don't matter which one I put it in. And then we got the strawberry kiwi. And I'm gonna have to put strawberry kiwi on the jar because I have two reds. Strawberry kiwi and that one's kind of like pink though. I'm still gonna put it. Get my little marker. SK. All right, and I'm just gonna stir the strawberry. Let me not scratch my face when I'm with this stuff. Okay, that's pretty good. I'm cool with that color. Yeah, I'm okay with that color. Actually, I don't even care. I'm gonna use the same spoon. I know you're like, but you mixing the flavors. Oh yeah, I'm definitely good with the color. I'm not gonna mix the two reds. That was a lighter red. This is the cherry. I'm not gonna put this spoon in there with that. I'm just gonna shake that because I think that's gonna, it almost like it's trying to come out like a cream as well. I'm not gonna put that back in there because that's gonna make that even more red. I'll just shake it. So let me get some more gloves. I don't know why I feel like I heard somebody say, where your hand at it? I ain't got no hair. I do got hair, but shit. Child, you'll get hair off my arms before you get it off my head. All right. I do not have to put on two gloves. I do not. But I took out another one. Okay, so I think I'm going to do the, I don't know why I feel like that cherry going to be the one. Okay, these are for you. These are for you, and those are for this one, okay? So let's go one at a time. I'm just gonna take these. I'm hoping I'm in the frame, child. Cause I'm good for not being in the frame, child. I just be doing stuff. All right, definitely don't wanna talk over nothing. My face don't do nothing too much, you know. So we just gonna toss these back on up in there. Mm-hmm. That's our first six. Put that on there. Just slide it to the side, child. I ain't ready for it yet. Bring this on over. Come on over. I sound better when I get my voice back. I'm excited for this. I'm excited to just like to try it. I'm really excited to like try it. I've heard people who don't even like pickles and they like, but I eat that though. Or there's the people who like, I don't like pickles and I still wouldn't eat pickles if they taste like that. But if I had to eat it, I'd eat it like that. Heard that too. All right, and this is the one I'm just going to have to shake and hope it get it, child. Hope it get it. It's going to get it. We go. We just trying this. We gonna see if it's a hit. It's gonna be a thing. It's gonna be a thing. Let me know. All right, let me take this last glove off before I shake, shimmy the sillies out. Before I jump, shake and shimmy to clean that up. Make sure the top one now. And I just want to give this one a little, just a little washing machine action.
Do the washing machine.
Shout out to Dawn Taman if you know. You know. Ooh, that is a pretty color. It's like a green color, but it's like you know it's blue. Oh my gosh, there's so much Kool-Aid at the bottom. I'm gonna have to do the turbo washing machine, bitch. That ain't do shit. All right, that's one. I feel like I'm at Showtime at the Apollo. You want some more tuna, Spirit? Spirit.
Child, Spirit is
best. Nervous about this one because all the goddamn Kool-Aid at the bottom.
Why didn't you just go grab a spoon? Why?
Now you up here vigorously jostling your pickles now. Okay, that's it. And now we got the jar. And you can kind of really just them up over there. All right. Okay. And I just want to make sure that all the pickles are pretty much covered and in there, which they are. I feel like they good. I mean, of course, I wish I had a little bit more juice, but I mean, looking at this one, it's almost like they're not touching the bottom. They're really not touching the bottom, Mike. And I think eventually they will, but I just want to kind of make sure that they're all touching the liquid. And that's what they're doing. So if it takes some time for them to settle, I don't know if you have to burp the container or nothing, but yeah, So this is strawberry kiwi. As you can see, like I said, they're not touching the bottom. That's strawberry kiwi. This is blue raspberry lemonade. Excited about that. And this is cherry. Excited about that. Now, according to Lady D, she told me I'm supposed to leave these in the refrigerator and put my fridge out for about 7 to 10 days. She said that's the best. Now, I'm probably, or did she say 5 to? I think she said 7 to 10, or she might have said 5 to 5, something like that. My baby comes back in 5 days. So I'm thinking that if I don't do it that day, as soon as she come back, I might give it 2 more days because she got to go to school and stuff. And then we got the weekend. So yeah, we will be back. We will be back to test these bad boys out.